Hey there, this is David, David Kwan, and you are me, actually. You're 17. I am 25, almost 26, actually. So at this point, I think you and I share a lot of similarities, or starting to share a lot of similarities. I've changed a lot as a person, but finally, a lot of that change you've already undergone. So a great deal of you is who I am now still. So great aspects of who you are now hasn't changed until you become 25, really. So that's an interesting to take note of. But it's also interesting to me that even as a 17-year-old, I didn't know what social work was. And I had no idea I would end up with a bachelor's degree in social work in New York City, of all places. So interesting thing how that happened. Yeah, definitely an interesting story there. So yeah, you applied to 5 colleges, right? And every single college except for one, you apply to major in history. You love history. You love learning, because you consider them like stories. You love learning about these stories, and you know, it engrosses you. But then with one school, NYU, you actually don't apply for a major in history. You apply for something else. You apply to NYU's Gallatin School of Individualized Study. You did that because you can create your own major. And you thought, hey, I have this idea. I love history. And I think history can be used for something really positive. Like helping the world with knowledge of history, like volunteering and kind of doing activism work, helping people, you know, helping people who are homeless or who are poor, whatever, using historical knowledge or sociological knowledge to do that. That's the major that you wanted to create because you didn't think it existed. You didn't know what kind of major that would be. So you applied to NYU saying that you wanted to create that kind of major. Well, guess what? That's pretty much what social work is. And that's pretty much what NYU told you. NYU emailed you back a month later, or will email you back a month later. So NYU emailed back a month later in your future, and they'll say that you should apply to School of Social Work. And then you'll be like, what is that? What is social work? That question drives you. And you're going to start researching a lot about what that is. And you're going to like it. So that's how you end up applying again to NYU, because you apply to everywhere else with the major in history. And you apply to NYU School of Social Work, and you get accepted. You get accepted into 3 colleges in the future. You get accepted into UC Irvine, Cal State Bakersfield, and NYU. So in CSUB and UC Irvine, they accept you for a history major, which you would still love doing. But then, you know, you're still going through this. Well, you now completed your deconversion process. You know, you finalized that in a way. I mean, you're still being a closeted atheist to your parents right now, which I know is a challenge. I know you're angry at the world kind of thingy right now. You'll get through it. It'll take 2 years, but you'll get through it. But yeah, the idea of living in New York City excites you, will excite you, and you end up going there, and your parents are very supportive. At this point, your mom makes a ton of money, and she's, you know, you are now, you're very privileged in this currently, as a 17-year-old. Your household income is really high. It's ridiculous. It's like, well, including if I count my dad, if you count your dad's income as a pastor, shoot, oh man, your household is a upper middle class or even lower upper class, I would say, at this point, because this is what, 2006, 2005, and your family's it's like $130,000 a year. That's your family income. Pretty amazing. So that's why you think it's possible to have your parents as co-signers, and you know, and go to NYU, you know, it's expensive, but with that kind of household support backing you up, I mean, you really didn't think it was going to be a huge problem. And also, social work is kind of a field. After you research, you do realize that social work is a type of field where after your degree, you're connected to a job right away. So this kind of reasoning how you end up in New York City majoring in social work. The future is not easy. I can tell you that much. Things don't go as planned, but they rarely do in life. You know, things don't go as planned, but that's how you end up. In some ways, I don't know. It's an interesting thing. Should you have ended up majoring in social work instead of history? Should you have ended up in New York instead of staying in California? Those are interesting questions, but this is yet again coming to New York City and living here by yourself, majoring in social work. This is yet again another important turning point in your life. It does change you in some ways. It makes you grow into become a different sort of person into who I am now. That itself, living by yourself in New York City, majoring in social work, graduating in social work, and working in nonprofit field and volunteering in nonprofits, it's an experience. And it is a turning point in your life. Is it inevitable? That question is up for grabs. But yeah, that's how you turn out to be here. And I always do wonder, what if, you know, I didn't end up here? What if I did major in history in a school in California? Things would be a lot different, definitely. And I don't know where I would be if that was the case as a 25-year-old after that. That's an interesting thing to ponder upon, but it's kind of pointless because this is how the future turned out for me. But yeah, so that's the video. Cheers.